Outgoing Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte led the commemoration of the country's 124th Independence Day at the Rizal Park in Manila Sunday. For the first and last time in his six-year stint as president, Duterte led the raising of the Philippine flag and offered a wreath and salute in front of the monument of national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal. Joining Duterte in the rites were Defense Secretary Delphine Lorenzana, National Historical Commission of the Philippines Chairperson Rene Escalante, and Armed Forces of the Philippines Chief of Staff General Andres Cetino, as well as other cabinet secretaries and officials. In a message, the Chief Executive urged Filipinos to continue believing there is still wisdom to be gained from our present choices, decisions, and actions. So he asked that the lessons of the past not be forgotten. He also urged the public to engage in healthy yet meaningful discourse without sowing hatred and division. Vice President Lenny Robredo's Independence Day message also highlighted the need to assert the truths in the country's history.
Maging bukas at mapagmahal, tumulong sa nangangailangan, idiin ang tama at makatarungan, at laging igiit ang katotohanan ng kasaysayan. Humugot ng inspirasyon sa isa't isa, lalo na sa mga nauna. Manindigan sa iisang kwentong hindi kailanman mababago, maaagaw o mabubura.
Defense Secretary Delphine Lorenzana is in stable condition after fainting during the Independence Day celebration at Rizal Park on Sunday. In this video, Lorenzana can be seen falling to the ground as he lost consciousness. Manila Mayor-elect Honey Lacuna, who was standing behind him, tried to break his fall. Other personnel also rushed to the secretary's aid and was immediately taken to the hospital. Hours after the incident, Lorenzana posted a photo of himself in much better spirits. He said his lack of sleep due to successive international security arrangements or engagements, plus the hot weather in Luneta on Sunday, may have taken their toll on him. Senator Bongo says Lorenzana also seemed to be doing better when he and President Duterte checked in on him via a video call. They both wished the defense chief well.
President-elect Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. also wished Filipinos a happy Independence Day. In his latest YouTube blog, the incoming Philippine leader expressed hope that Filipinos will find inspiration from the country's heroes who use their intelligence and bravery to fight off oppressors.
Nasa ang dako mang kayo ng mundo, maligayang araw ng kalayaan. Mula sa kagitingan at pagkakaisa na ipinamalas ng ating mga ninuno, mula sa kanilang talino at galing at tapat upang makatayo tayo sa ating sariling mga paa, dito nagmula ang ating kalayaan.
Marcos also hoped for freedom from the COVID-19 pandemic and the so-called cancel culture as he begins his term as president in just a few weeks.
Ang kapakanan ng ating mga manggagawa, ang ating mga maliliit na negosyo, ang iba't iba pang mga sektor na hanggang ngayon ay hindi pa nakabalik sa normal. Iyan ang mga patuloy pa naming tinatalakay kasama ng lahat ng pinakamagagaling na eksperto. Cancel culture man ito, discrimination, mga violenting hate crime, lahat yan ay hindi nakatanggap-tanggap sa ating makabagong panahon. Sana ay huwag tayong magpasakop sa ganitong pag-iisip. Paluwigin ang ating pagrespeto, pagtanggap, at pag-unawa sa isa't isa.
Outgoing Vice President Lenny Robredo says she hopes her successor will continue the projects her office started. Robredo said in her Sunday radio program that they are positively conducting transition meetings with the team of Vice President-elect Sara Duterte Carpio, but she notes has been very receptive. She also assured that Duterte Carpio's administration will continue her medical assistance programs. Robredo also noted that preparations are in place for Angat Buhay NGO, which is expected to be formally launched on July 1.
So undergoing registration. Inahabol namin sana ka-edit na by July 1 lumabas na yung approval ng ating registration. Wala na tayong government office. Talaga ito pure na NGO. Magda-downsize yung Angat Buhay dahil syempre kukonte yung resources. Aasa tayo sa mga volunteers. At syempre yung pondo dahil walang government office na magbaba sa atin. At yung pondo ay galing lahat sa mga volunteers.
Robredo returned to her radio program a month after the May 9 polls with only 18 days left in her tenure before leaving office on June 30. She lost to former Senator Bongbong Marcos in the presidential race. Sorsogon's Mount Bulusan erupts anew, this time spewing more ash compared to last week's explosion. There was almost zero visibility in the town of Huban due to the ash fall. State volcanologists say the phreatic explosion lasted for 18 minutes during the early hours of Sunday. The agency warning more explosions are possible.
Mas malakas itong kanina madaling araw. Hindi naman siguro sa taas lang kasi more or less parang kapareho lang taas. Minsan, yung seismic signal, yung counts na tinatawag namin or yung energy, nagdedepende yan kung ano, kung maraming abo ba ang kasama doon sa pagsabog.
Ashfall also hit parts of Irosin, Casiguran, Castilla, and reached as far as Sorsogon City. However, the alert level in the province is unchanged and no forced evacuation was implemented. Residents were only advised to stay indoors. Sorsogon Governor Cheese Escudero has also decided not to declare a state of calamity for now.
Ang order is to stay indoor and then madaling araw kaya nasa loob naman lang ng mga bahay. So sa ngayon medyo ano naman base dito sa as of now na ano panahon natin, medyo humuhupa naman na.
Food for work ang binibigay ng lalawigan upang sa gayon magkaroon naman ng dignidad ang muling pagbangon ng aming mga kababayan mula sa anumang uri ng sakit.